I am calm. I am calm. It is the calm before something awful, the yellow minute before the wind walks when the leaves turn up their hands, their pallors. It is so quiet here. The sheets, the faces are white and stopped like clocks. Voices stand back and flatten their visible hieroglyphs. Flattened to parchment screens to keep the wind off, they paint such secrets in Arabic, Chinese. I am dumb and brown. I am a seed about to break. The brownness is my dead self, and it is sullen. I does not wish to be more or different. Dusk hoods me in blue now, like a Mary, a color of distance and forgetfulness. When will it be the second when time breaks and eternity engulfs it and I drown utterly? I talk to myself, myself only, set apart, swabbed and lurid with disinfectants, sacrificial, waiting, lies heavy on my lids. It lies like sleep, like a big sea far off, far off. I feel the first wave tug its cargo of agony toward me, inescapable, tidal, and I a shell echoing on this first white beach face the voices that overwhelm, the terrible element. I am a mountain now, among mountainy women. The doctors move among us as if our bigness frightens the mind. They smile like fools. They are to blame for what I am, and they know it. They hug their flatness like a kind of health, and what if they found themselves surpassed as I did? They would go mad with it. And what if two lives leaked between my thighs? I have seen the white clean chamber with its instruments. It is a place of shrieks. It is not happy. This is where you will come when you are ready. The night lights are flat red moons. They are dull with blood. I am not ready for anything to happen. I should have murdered this that murders me. There is no miracle more cruel than this. I am dragged by the horses, the iron hooves. I last it out. I accomplish a work, dark tunnel, through which hurtle the visitations, the manifestations, the startled faces. I am the center of an atrocity. What pains, what sorrows must I be mothering? Can such innocence kill and kill? It milks my life. The trees wither in the street. The rain is corrosive. I taste it on my tongue. And the workable horrors, the horrors that stand and idle, the slighted godmothers with their hearts that tick and tick, with their satchels of instruments. I shall be a wall and a roof protecting. I shall be a sky and a hill of good. Oh, let me be. A power is growing on me, an old tenacity. I am breaking apart like the world. There is this blackness, this ram of blackness. I fold my hands on a mountain. The air is thick. It is thick with this working. I am used. I am drummed into use. My eyes are squeezed by this blackness. I see nothing. I am accused. I dream of massacres. I am a garden of black and red agonies. I drink them, hating myself, hating and fearing. And now the world conceives it. Ends and runs toward it, arms held out in love. It is a love of death that sickens everything. A dead sun stains the newsprint. It is red. I lose life after life. The dark earth drinks them. She is the vampire of us all. So she supports us, fattens us, is kind. Her mouth is red. I know her. I know her intimately. Our old winter face, old barren one, old time bomb. Men have used her meanly. She will eat them, eat them, eat them, eat them. In the end, the sun is down. I die. I make a death. Who is he? This blue, furious boy, shining and strange as if he had hurtled from a star. He is looking so angrily. He flew into the room, a shriek at his heel. The blue color pales. He is human after all. A red lotus opens in its bowl of blood. They are stitching me up with silk as if I were a material. What did my fingers do before they held him? What did my heart do with its love? I have never seen a thing so clear. His lids are like the lilac flower. Soft as a moth his breath I shall not let go. There is no guile or warp in him. May he keep so.